Welcome back to another episode of The Curtis Zone. I am your humble and handsome host, Dylan J. Curtis, and we thank you for hitting that like and subscribe button for more content from here from The Curtis Zone. From me, my smiling face, and of course, my bouncing pecs. Today is another pull list episode. We're talking about how it would look if Marvel's Illuminati had Green Lantern rings, had lantern rings, any lantern ring. Right, and I'm not talking about the MCU Illuminati from Doctor Strange Multiverse of Madness. I'm talking about Marvel's Illuminati, which originally consisted of Tony Stark Iron Man, Professor Charles Xavier or Professor X, Black Bolt of the Inhumans, Doctor Strange, Namor the Submariner, Mr. Fantastic, and briefly Black Panther. But since Black Panther was briefly on the team, we're not going to talk about that. And as always, remember, if you have any questions, comments, concerns, or if you just want to make a request for any episode period, leave it in the comment section down below. There are only three pieces of news I'm going to give to you guys. The first piece is that Michael Keaton plans to return to the DCU as Batman, as Bruce Wayne for a live-action Batman Beyond movie. It has finally been confirmed. Nothing is set in stone on story, cast, or anything else, but we can't wait nonetheless. The next piece of news we're going to give to you guys is the fact that Sonic the Hedgehog 3 has a final release date and cast set. Now, we're not going to spoil anything, just read the news. The final piece of news I'm going to give to you guys is the fact that Grant Gustin the Flash has been confirmed for the upcoming The Batman 2. Is he playing the Flash? Is he not? Or is he just playing a different character? We don't know. Now, let's get into today's episode. We asked ourselves, what if Marvel's Illuminati were part of Lantern Corps? Now, there are many Lantern Corps that span the different emotional spectrums. You have green, which as we all know is the element of will. You have yellow, the element of fear. Red of rage, blue of hope, orange of greed, purple of compassion, pink of love. Then there's the white lanterns of life and the black lanterns of death. Let's get into the episode, and remember, hit that like and subscribe button. Quick origin on Marvel's Illuminati. They first met after the Kree and Skrull War in Wakanda, and they were hosted by King T'Challa himself. Tony Stark suggested that they needed to form a team, all of them together, in order to fight against another threat, because they were formed after the Kree and Skrull War. But they all refused and instead asked that they meet in secret. After a little bit of arguing here and there and a death threat from Namor the Submariner himself, they all agreed to form an Illuminati. No, they do not involve their families or their other teammates, especially when it comes to meetings about the Illuminati. A little bit more about the Illuminati, they would be able to be part of multiple storylines in the Marvel Universe, including kicking off the Planet Hulk and World War Hulk storyline. They're also originally a part of the Infinity War storyline, where they would divide up the Infinity Stones. So yeah, they're very powerful because they're comprised of the smartest and most influential beings in the Marvel Universe. Iron Man had his chest blown open after he was kidnapped by a criminal organization, but his willingness to survive and his background in engineering has earned him a Green Lantern ring. So I think that Iron Man would be a Green Lantern because the Green Lanterns are warriors of will, and Iron Man has will like nobody's business. Also, John Stewart is known as the Master Builder, and I think that Iron Man would be one of the Master Builders due to the fact that he has a background in engineering. Oh, and did I mention the Amalgamous comic books, where Iron Man and Green Lantern became Iron Lantern? Pretty cool stuff if you ask me. Everyone knows that Namor the Submariner is Marvel's King of Atlantis. But what they don't know about him is that he's one of those kings who is, I am for my people, only my people type kings. Which is why I believe that Namor the Submariner would be a Red Lantern. The Red Lanterns are the Lanterns of Rage. They embody the element of rage due to the fact that Atrocitus saw a devastation of his planet and the Red Lantern gave him the power to get revenge. They embody revenge like nobody's business, and I believe that Namor would be a part of them because he wants revenge on the humans that took his mother. So yeah, Namor would be a Red Lantern. As we all know, Professor Charles Xavier runs the X-Men, and the X-Men's only job is to protect people who hate and fear them because they are mutants. So, Professor X has hope that the X-Men and all mutants around the world will be accepted by humanity, which is why I strongly believe that he will be a Blue Lantern. The Blue Lanterns embody the elements of hope, and the Hope Lanterns, their main protocol is every time they get a new lantern, they send that new lantern to find another new lantern. Which is why I believe that if Professor Charles Xavier were to become a Blue Lantern, the entire X-Men would be Blue Lanterns. So yeah, Charles Xavier, he'd be a Blue Lantern. Black Bolt is king of the Inhumans and keeper of the Terrigen Mist. He cannot speak because his voice has the power to shatter entire dimensions. If he were to yell, if he were to whisper, he could shatter entire worlds. His love for his people and for his wife Medusa has earned him a Pink Lantern or a Violet Lantern or the Star Sapphires. The Star Sapphires embody the power of love, and they use their love to bring order to the universe. After they followed in the Guardians' footsteps and created a core out of and rings out of the Star Sapphire gems. The first Star Sapphire was Carol Ferris in the Silver Age comic books, but this grew into a core. So yes, I believe that Black Bolt would embody the power of the Violet Lanterns. Everyone who's anyone knows that Reed Richards is part of Marvel's first family, the Fantastic Four, the leader, no doubt. They also know that he's one of the smartest characters in all of Marvel, and he abhors the idea of violence, which is why I believe that he will be part of the Indigo Lanterns, or the Indigo Tribe. For those of you who don't know, the Indigo Tribe embody the power of compassion, and once struck by the power of an Indigo Ring, all their enemies felt compassion and remorse for all the evil that they've ever done. Which is why Abin Sur used the Indigo Lantern and created the Indigo Tribe. They use a staff as their lantern, and they also have Indigo Rings. And their Lantern Court oath is in another language, but which is why I'm not even going to try and translate it. But I believe that Reed Richards, Mr. Fantastic, would be a part of the Indigo Tribe. Everyone who is anyone knows about Doctor Strange and the fact that he is the Sorcerer Supreme of the Marvel Universe. His job is to protect all life in the Marvel Universe from other dimensions, including Dormammu, leader of the Dark Dimension. It's because of this, which is why I believe Doctor Strange would be part of the White Lantern Corps. You see, the White Lanterns utilize all the other Lantern Corps as their own weapons, especially during the Blackest Night prophecy, when they would bring back everyone who died in the DC Universe as part of the White Lantern Corps. You know, like they always do with the DC Universe. The White Lanterns are the most powerful lanterns in all of DC comic books, which is why I believe that Doctor Strange could utilize the White Lanterns. However, the White Lanterns can only be used for a short time, lest they destroy the wearer. But Doctor Strange can handle it.
And that brings another episode of The Curtis Zone to a screeching close, ladies and gentlemen. Remember, hit the like and subscribe button for more content from The Curtis Zone. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, or if you just want to make a request for any episode, period, leave it down there. And we want to thank today's sponsor, Coastal Waste and Recycling, for sponsoring this episode. And we want to also thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys later.